Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's examine what we know so far about Mac OS X Mavericks. So Mavericks is going to be the successor to Mountain Lion. Mountain Lion was 10.8, Mavericks will be 10.9. And it's named not after a cat, but a place in California, a famous surfing spot near Half Moon Bay. So here's what we know about it so far. They're going to be Finder changes, most notably Finder tabs. So a Finder window can now, instead of just containing a single list of files or folders, can actually have multiple tabs, just like Safari can show multiple web pages. And you can switch between these tabs. This will make it a lot easier to have one Finder window open and access several folders in there that you need to get to, rather than having multiple Finder windows lined up or overlapping each other. Now there's also going to be an emphasis on file tagging. That's not exactly something that's completely new. So file tagging is the ability to apply a keyword to a file. So think of it as you have your file name, which is the title of the document, but you can also apply multiple keywords to it. Say if it's something for work, something for a special project, something for home. And these are kind of similar to how we had labels before, but you can have multiple tags applied instead of just one label. And it looks like actually they'll be just extending labels to create these tags. So think of tags as a combination of labels and also spotlight comments, which allowed you previously to enter in keywords that you could find when searching for the file. And also in addition to that, smart folders, because you'll be able to then look at the different items that have different keywords on the left. So if you tag something as being from work and a certain project, you'll be able to look in these folders that will show you everything that's tagged with that. So you'll find files in multiple places, maybe under multiple keywords and in the actual folder they're located. Very similar to how in iTunes you have playlists and in iPhoto you have albums as well as events. Mavericks is also going to change how multiple screens are handled, specifically when it comes to things that kind of get in the way of multiple screens, like mission control, which works great if you have one screen like on a laptop, but you have multiple screens and it kind of gets a little confusing. Well, with Mavericks now, each screen will have its own mission control and you'll be able to have multiple spaces with each screen. Likewise, each screen will have its own dock, so you can go to the bottom of each screen and get the dock there. And another thing about screens is that it looks like we'll be able to use Apple TV as a second monitor. Not a mirrored one as we can now with Mountain Lion and AirPlay, but actually creating a new screen that's then shown wirelessly using Apple TV. Now as predicted, Mavericks is going to get rid of some or maybe all skeuomorphic designs. This is when an app kind of looks like something in the real world, like kind of the leathery feel of Calendar or the legal pad feel of Notes. We don't know exactly which ones are going to go to a very plain flat look. We know Calendar is one of them, but perhaps we could see Notes and Reminders do the same as well. So there'll be a new version of Safari, and it looks like the main change is going to be combining several elements into one interface. You had top sites before, we had bookmarks, we had reading list. It's all going to be combined, so there'll be reading list and bookmarks in the left sidebar, as well as links from your social networks. And the top sites can appear to the right of that, as well as web pages appear to the right of that. So kind of a new control center way of navigating your web pages while having a left sidebar that lets you get to things. So making Safari maybe a little bit more like Mail, where you have a left sidebar and a right area where you're viewing things. Of course, I'm sure you'll be able to just simply view things as you could before. Safari is also going to get a little faster, as there'll be some JavaScript engine improvements. Now there'll be a new part of iCloud that seems to me to be kind of a replacement for 1Password or LastPass, something that lets you save passwords securely and other information like credit card info and then enter into your browser. And it looks like this is going to sync across devices, which will be useful. I'm not so sure it's going to completely replace things like 1Password. It was kind of strange in the presentation how you couldn't actually have your 3-digit credit card code included in it, even though there shouldn't be any real reason not to if it's securely encrypted and you have to use your password to get to it. So we'll have to see how this feature actually plays out, whether it's kind of a halfway step to something like 1Password or whether it can completely replace it. It looks like we're going to get an iBooks app that will allow us to access iBooks, things we've purchased on our iPad or iPhone, also on our Mac. Now this is going to be great because it allows an expansion of the number of people that can use iBooks. So for instance, if you're in school and use a MacBook, then you may not have had access to the iBooks textbooks. You had to get an iPad to do that. Now you can do that on your Mac. Or if you have both devices, you can use them on both because you purchase on one, you get them on all, just like with music and apps. And also it looks like things like notes and bookmarks and all sorts of things will sync between them using iCloud. In addition, a cool feature looks like you'll be able to open multiple books at the same time. So for students having to look at multiple textbooks at once, you'll be able to have them open in multiple windows. Another new app will be the Maps app. So this is going to have the same functionality we get in iOS, but you'll be able to do it on the Mac, which is great because unlike Google Maps, there's no web-based version of Apple Maps. So now you have a way to access them. And also another great thing is that the SDK will allow third-party developers to be able to use Maps in their apps. They can already do that on iOS, but the ability to do that on the Mac might create some really cool innovative apps on your Mac that pull in Maps data and allow you to do location-based things. So now to the nitty-gritty details. First of all, when will Mavericks come out? Well, all we know is it's going to be this fall. So anytime between the end of September to the end of December. So my bet's somewhere around November. Maybe just in time so that anybody buying Macs for the holidays will get Mavericks installed. But we'll have to see. Apple sometimes has been known to wait to the very last day of the season when they promise something like fall or spring. So how about compatibility? Which Macs will Mavericks be compatible with? Well, we don't have any information about that right now except some leaked information from developers that's been posted to rumor sites that seem to point to that anything that can run Mount Lion can run Mavericks, which kind of makes sense. But we'll have to wait until the end. It probably will be a few borderline Macs that just can barely run Mount Lion now that will be left out of Mavericks as some of the new features may not work on those machines. How about pricing? Well, if we look back at Mount Lion, Mount Lion cost $10. Look before that at Lion, it cost $20. My bet is it's going to be one of those two, $10 or $20. And how will you get it? Well, you're going to have to get it from the Mac App Store, I'm sure of that, because the last two operating systems have been distributed that way. So you'll most likely need to have either Lion or Mount Lion installed, although perhaps with a later version of Snow Leopard if your Mac's compatible, you also have the Mac App Store and you might be able to jump straight to Mavericks. So here's what we know so far. There'll probably be a lot more information given out by Apple or leaked by developers who have access to Mavericks right now. But keep in mind with leaked information is that developers could be misinterpreting features or there could be features that could be in there that Apple then pulls before the final version. Also, there's things that might be independent of Mavericks, like iBooks and Maps apps could be released beforehand or could be released after Mavericks comes out because they may be completely independent of the operating system itself. We'll just have to see how it goes this fall. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.